What's going on, YouTube? This is Necrostevo, and it's time for another battle with one of my excellent rivals, Chewie, or Mike Hobbs on Twitter. I will leave his Twitter information in the description. This actually was a battle we had a long time ago, and it was a start of a long gauntlet of battles. He and I are in different time zones, and so normally he'll tweet at me saying, hey, do you want to have a battle? Probably on a Sunday. I go, sure, what are you thinking? And we come up with a battle that has just some weird rules. So in this battle, we kind of just had something from a little bit of everything here. We just said something from each tier. Let's go. The deal was, though, no OU Pokemon. So that's why our teams are how they are. I have some nice shenanigans going on here. First of all, we have the Me First Absol, which, of course, if you know how Me First works, it kind of cuts in front of the opposing Pokemon, and if they're going to use an offensive move, it uses that move with 1.5 times power. So really, really nice for Pokemon that carry moves that are super effective against themselves when they don't have, when you or your Absol doesn't have that coverage option. I also have a nice Life Orb Electivire, defensive Hitmontop, that's General Gyro this time, not Colonel Twist. Harbinger is my dual screens Meowstic. Sunny Day Venusaur, just to set up its own sun and then try to do some sweeping action. And then Silk Scarf Bouffalant there, just to try to break some holes in the opposing team. Looking at his team, Oshawott did not see that coming. Definitely, I know that's one of his favorite Pokemon. But I was like, Oshawott, what's that going to do? Little did I know what Oshawott can do. It's even better than Ashes. It can see underwater from the start. We do see three water types on this team, so that makes Electivire pretty important for this matchup. Malamar is kind of annoying just because I have some things weak to fighting, and also Malamar gets that nice plus one boost from my Intimidate if I bring in Hitmontop at the wrong time. And based on his team structure, I was actually expecting Steelix to be Mega. But if it wasn't Mega, I was like, great, I can stand here and 2-hit KO with Earthquake, let's go! And then it barely does, like a third. I was a little bit disappointed by that damage, actually. But that's okay, his Stealth Rocks are up, but I have General Gyro to get rid of those. So we're going to switch out right now. I figured he'd go for Earthquake, and I wanted to bring in General Gyro before he brings in Malamar. And so if he did go for Earthquake, Intimidate would cut that damage down nicely. But he switches out 2 into Malamar, so that worked out pretty well. He doesn't get the boost on his Malamar from Contrary. And I get a free Rapid Spin off here, which is perfect. Now, I actually was hoping that he would overpredict. Psycho Cut is a little bit risky to go for when I can just switch in Absol. At the same token, I can't really just switch in Absol because he could go for Superpower. But he does just go straight for Psycho Cut. I'm going to hold on to General Gyro because I do have priority with its Mach Punch. It doesn't hit very hard, but it's nice to pick off some things. And this is a free chance to Mega Evolve with my Absol. And go for some. I have Knock Off, I have Sucker Punch, I have Me First, and Play Rough. So basically walled by a few Pokemon, but Play Rough and Knock Off is fantastic neutral coverage. I'm hoping for a Fairy Dark type in the future. That would work really, really well with the whole idea of the Fey or Evil Fairies, as it were. Now with Ludicolo in here, I can go out into Venusaur, expecting the grass type move or maybe the water type move. If he went for Ice Beam, it wouldn't KO Venusaur either. So this is not a terrible choice. Now as I go for Sunny Day, I was hoping that Venusaur could one-hit KO Malamar. Malamar doesn't have stellar defenses or anything. And this is a modest Venusaur Sludge Bomb. It actually does a pretty good amount of damage, but since I have a Heat Rock and nothing to boost my damage output, that's not going to cut it. And I actually bred that Venusaur, so I was quite proud of that one, getting a nice shiny there. It's so much more impactful for me when I breed them and I get shinies. It's just like kind of exciting at the time. But I am gonna go straight for a knockoff here. We get rid of Steelix's leftovers. I go for Me First expecting Earthquake, but he goes for Stealth Rock and bounces it back. I don't know if he expected me to switch out expecting the Earthquake. I didn't really know what was going on there. Here I go for Sucker Punch, expecting him to go for something other than Earthquake because now he's seen the Me First, but now he goes for the Earthquake, and I'm going to try to go for Me First again as he switches out into Malamar. Me First is just not working out, and I really want that move to work out, darn it. That move is a cool move, and it needs more usage. I do wish that it had increased priority and didn't rely on speed, but you know, that's not terrible. as far as, you know, moves that kind of rely on different speed tiers. I figured he was actually probably going to rapid spin with his Blastoise as I bring in my Electivire, but he actually just brings it in and he goes for Fake Out, which was not expected at all, but it gives my Electivire a free kill, so we're okay with that. Take a lot of recoil damage between Life Orb and the Wild Charge recoil. No, that's okay. I went for Ice Punch here, expecting him to double into his Steelix. Ice Punch was a nice middle ground option, whereas Wild Charge would have KO'd the Ludicolo. But I figured if he didn't go for Scald, he wouldn't be able to KO me anyway. He goes for Ice Beam there. Thank goodness, because that means I'm not KO'd. Flamethrower is enough to take down Ludicolo. He's going to go out into Oshawott, and I was like, what can Oshawott do here? And as I clicked Wild Charge, I remembered, oh yeah, Samurai gets Aqua Jet. And then Oshawott picks up a KO. That's just not a situation that I'm used to in battles. Now here, I figure Hitmontop can come in, get the Intimidate off, and can probably 2-hit KO it with Mach Punch. But that's not even enough to our 2-hit KO, and the Oshawott is faster than my Hitmontop. What? I'm resisting saying Oshawott for a reason. That pun is too easy. You should be ashamed if you make that specific pun. Far too easy. We are highbrow humor here. Highbrow getting KO'd by waterfalls. I would go chasing waterfalls, but Oshawott is now KO'd. That is the only time I've ever had any of my Pokemon in a mixed tier battle get KO'd by an Oshawott. And it will probably be the last time, because next time I won't underestimate it. Finally get my me first shenanigans off. Finally, Absol can't even learn Earthquake, and I get to use it, and it's super effective, and it's 50% more powerful because I use me first. Finally. And just because now I know if he goes for Sleep Power, it bounces it back. Let's just go for me first again. I get to use his Power Whip against him. Let's go. Why not? I didn't want to go for Knockoff because there are no style points in Knockoff, and Carnivine is a cool Pokemon, so you must defeat it with style. Unfortunately, I underestimate how strong Carnivine is as he knocks out my Absol. I failed to KO it with a Psychic right here. I know that this Meowstic isn't invested in special attack at all, but Carnivine doesn't have great defenses. I am going to throw up a Reflect here just to ensure that my Bouffalant can live hits from it in case, you know, something goes weird and I miss a move or he goes for Sleep Powder or anything like that. That just kind of seals up the deal perfectly. So we get to end this battle as it started with a gigantic truckload of Bull just running right through him. So thank you very much, Chewie, for that battle. You guys look forward to more battles that I have with Mike Hobbs. We have an entire gauntlet that I must go through because these battles are so epic and awesome. If you did enjoy this video, feel free to find me on Twitter for a mixed tier battle where you can bring your own stage one starter and basic form starter and knock out two of my Pokemon with, because I can say I've never had that happen before. And now it's chronicled on the internet forever. So that's a fun thing. I'll talk to you guys later. Have a great day. Bye now.